guys, this is me, Asta. Merry Christmas and a very happy new year to everyone. So don't forget to study amidst all the celebration. So to remind you of it, I'm up with my new video again. And today we're going to be talking about our Paleolithic sites. So the important thing that you need to remember about it is the technical advancement. So they started making parallel sided blades. And there was also increase in number of burins. The trend was towards smaller tools. And this must happen because of the adaptation to the environmental changes. It is known, for instance, that the climate of northern and western India seems to have become increasingly very arid during the Upper Paleolithic age. Older tools types also continued, and they for the activities that required heavy tools. So now let's move to the sites. So I have categorized it here: northwest, central, northeastern, and south. So in the northwest, this Shanghao cave have given evidence of middle and upper Paleolithic tools, hearts, animal bones, what appeared to be burials. Upper Paleolithic tools have been found in Rohiri Hills in Upper Sindh and Milestone 101 in Lower Sindh. In North India, Kashmir, Upper Paleolithic have been dated to about 18,000 before present and coincides with the onset of milder climate. In the Thar, the number of Paleolithic sites is fewer than those of preceding phase due to increasing aridity. However, there is continuing human occupation around Buddha Pushkar Lake. In central India, Upper Paleolithic habitation sites have been found in caves and rock shelters of the Vindhyas. Now, another site, Chupani Mandu in Belan Valley, it seems to be a habitation site and with a cultural sequence from Upper Paleolithic to Neolithic. The Upper Paleolithic assemblage consists of tools made from chait, a stone available in the nearby Vindhyas. The animal bones discovered in the Belan Valley included those of wild cattle, sheep and goat. Since sheep and goat do not seem to be indigenous to this area, they may have been bought from the northwest. If this was indeed the case, it could represent an early stage of animal domestication. So here we get the evidence of animal domestication from this area. So some sites that you need to remember are in northwest are Shanghao Cave, then Buddha Pushkar Lake and some valleys, okay? And here, now let's come to central India. We talked about Chupani Mandu in Belan Valley. Now let's come to Madhya Pradesh. In Madhya Pradesh, in Siddhi district, in the valley of Son River, an archaeological team led by G.R. Sharma and G.D. Clark, they excavated the Upper Paleolithic site of Bagor 1. A subsequent microwave study of site Bagor 3, not far from Bagor 1, it throws light on the subsistence activity of the place. So if you don't know what microwave study is, it's the study of stone tools, what they were used for and what kind of tools they used, etc. Okay. So the study identifies different kinds of activity that the stones found at the sites were used for. Some of these activities, such as boring, scraping, whittling, were probably related to craft work. Others, such as cutting, slicing, piercing, chopping, could have been associated with the food processing, hunting, or craft work. Microwave analysis, it identifies the proportion of tools used on vegetal material, those used for processing non-vegetal material, and those used to work on wood or bamboo to make hunting and gathering gear. Some tools showed a kind of wear and polish that indicated that they have been hafted onto handles. So now let's move to the eastern parts, northeastern parts. So there are many Upper Paleolithic sites in Chota Nagpur region and in the main area of Rajmahal Hill. These include Spasra and Munger district. And Upper Paleolithic tools have been found in various districts of West Bengal. There is not much evidence of Paleolithic phase in Assam and other parts of Northeast, but in the Lamai Hills of Bangladesh and in the Hora and Kovai region, river valley in West Tripura. So, and a number of tools, including typical Upper Paleolithic type, such as blades, burins, points, etc. made out of fossil wood have been found. So here I have given a miscellaneous point which is about Bangladesh and Myanmar. So these are not not inside India, that's why I have mentioned it differently. So, and also there's a similar tools that have been found in the upper Irrawaddy Valley in Myanmar. Okay, now let's come to south. So upper Paleolithic cave sites of Kurnool, Machhatala, Chintamanu, Gavi in Andhra Pradesh are the only places in the subcontinent where the tools made of animal bones have been found in an upper Paleolithic context. In one of the cave, as many as 90% of the excavated tools were made of this material. The faunal remains at the site includes those of bat, nilgai, four-horned antelope, gazelle, cheetal, sambar deer, barking deer, mouse deer, wild boar, tiger, leopard, jungle cat, rusty spotted cat, spotted hyena, freshwater fish, mongoose, etc. etc. Many animals, mouse, bush rat, black gnat hare, grey langur, baboon, horse, rhinoceros, many animals. So apart from giving valuable information about the animals, the Upper Paleolithic people shared their landscapes with. This list also suggests that the thick forests and more humid condition prevailed in this area. Upper Paleolithic artifacts were also found in the Renugunta in Chittor district of southern Andhra Pradesh. Stone tools of this phase occur in many places also along the east coast of Peninsula India. Okay, so that's it about this Upper Paleolithic age. We'll meet in another video, which would be about Paleolithic art and culture. So stay tuned to stay updated, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel.